Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. Now we need to discuss the second video on head section. Already we discussed five tags. We need to discuss last tag is the meta tag. This is the powerful tag in HTML. So similarly, in head section of a document provides extra information about the document as well as serving as a container for sections such as styles and global scripts. A document's head section begins with the opening head tag and the ends with the closing head tag. This is the syntax we are representing here, and we know that already in the head section consists of six tags. So title, link, base, script, style and meta. Okay, now we are moving to meta tag section. Meta tag enable web authors to embed an extra information in their documents. Meta tags are used to provide information to search engines, control browser, caching of the document. Most of the document's meta information is generated by the web server that delivers the document. I also add few things. Using meta tag, we are also doing search engine optimization. SEO, search engine optimization. If you here in the latter section, you know how it helps it. The tag is meta, name is equal to name of the data, and content is equal to data content we need to provide. So metadata is data about data. The meta tag provides metadata about the HTML document. Metadata will not be displayed on the page, but will be mission possible. Meta elements are typically used to specify the page description keywords, author of the document, last modified, and other meta elements. So description means we need to give very brief description about it. Whenever we are searching on the Google search, it fetch the details. And similarly, the keywords what we are giving, based on the keywords only it will gives. And we also specify the other details and last modified information provided. So the metadata can be used by browsers. How to display content or reload page, search engines keywords or other web services. So first one is define keywords for search engines. Meta name is equal to keywords, content is equal to, we need to specify the related web content related keywords we need to specify. Similarly, description, the name is the description, and we need to specify the small description about the web page. Unique description, unique keywords for each and every web page is required. So defining the author, so the meta name is author, and we need to write the name of the author. And the next one is refresh document. So here we are specifying 30 seconds of time. So refresh 30. So this is one of the powerful tool in HTML, means meta tag. Why? Because you know very well about whenever we are doing bank transactions, when we finally typed it, it takes some time for making it, and the financial transaction is done. So they displayed in that until unless the transaction is completed, do not refresh or go back. So the screen will be available for the time, and automatically it will be converted. That can be happened with the help of refresh. So already we know few attributes. Already we discussed name and content attributes. So apart from this, schema and HTTP equal. Schema is space a schema to interpret the property value. HTTP equal used for HTTP response message headers. For example, HTTP equal can be used to refresh the page or to set a cookie. Values include content type, expires, refresh, and set cookie. So name attribute values are keyword, already we seen, description, already we seen, refresh already we seen, other we seen. Apart from this, revisited, cookie, robots, catch control. So now, again we are in detail, we are learning it. So the keyword is this. And the description. When we are typing like this, this is the part where after searching in the Google, the description part is shown like this. Okay. Next one is name attribute description values. Revisited values. Revisited. When we revisited means when last updates will be defined with the keyword revisited. So the next one is refresh, already we discussed. And cookie. This cookie means to store cookies on client side, and later this information can be used by the web server to track a site visitor. So when it expires and when it starts, who is the main person, user ID, everything should be taken by the web server. And other already we discussed. And robots, it tells confirming robots not to index the current document or follow any links from it. And this is the catch control. If we provide no catch, or if we catch control max is good, so and so, it tells confirming robots not to index the current document or follow any link of this. Very clearly I need to tell that catch control means when the web server not working it, and with the help of the catch control we need to retrieve the last updated web page content, and it also can be viewed. Thank you.